Hi, I'm Chris Haig and this is the Fiddle Channel, and today we're going to play Brown Eyed Girl. Now, over the years, I've played in countless wedding bands, party bands, covers bands, and I think the lowest common denominator of all of those gigs has been Brown Eyed Girl. Even though there's no fiddle part in the original, it's one that every party band plays, and it works really nicely for the fiddle. So I'm going to do you a walkthrough where we try all the different parts and look at different approaches. It was written in 1966 by Van Morrison, obviously. He signed a very hasty contract on this one. I think he possibly didn't look at it, but it's something he regretted for the rest of his life, and still regrets because basically he made no money out of it whatsoever. But it did launch his career, so I think it's probably still his best known song and best loved. So we start off with an intro, which is on the guitar, and. First question is, who are you playing this with? Is it with the band? Does the band have a guitarist? Is he going to play exactly as it's on the original, or is he going to do a rough version of it, or what? So I'm going to give you, first of all, a one-line version and then a harmony version, which will harmonise with the guitar part. So, basic melody, I would say, for the intro is 1, 2, 3, 4... So we do that twice. If you want to harmonise it, then we're going to go with a third above and a sixth below. So we're going to start here. If you're unclear about how this harmony works, I have a video called The Scale of Sixths, which will kind of explain it. The only complication with this is that on the G chord you're playing an F sharp, and on the C chord you're playing a F natural. I'll just go through that again and watch for that. If you don't do that, if you play F sharps, then it's not going to make a big difference. But I have noticed, I've played this many times with the band Roller Coaster, a covers band that I do a lot with, and the guitarist always turns around when I play that particular note in the C chord. He gives me a look like he's just eaten a lemon. And I never knew why. I had no idea there was anything wrong with what I was doing until I sat down to work on this video and realised that you actually want an F natural in there. So, let's just do that intro with the backing. Right, what I'm going to give you now is basically the vocal melody, just for orientation really. It's probably not very likely that you're going to be actually playing the melody, but it'll help us to know where we are. Playing unison with the singer is usually not a good idea, I think particularly on this one. But let's hear it anyway. And we'll go into the bridge. So, in fact we'll do it with the backing, but when we get to the bridge, I'm going to put the little fills in as well. So just follow this. Oops. pretty straightforward, but you could actually not play anything on the first verse and that would be okay. There's always the danger of playing too much in these situations, and just dropping out on the first verse is often a good idea. What I'm going to give you now is the organ line, which is played on the organ on the original, and it's quite a nice line. First of all, I'll do it in single notes and then harmony. Extra bar on the original, and I think the general world has decided that bar is unnecessary because no one you ever play it with will play that bar, so we're going to leave that out. Then we go to the chorus, the shalalas. So again, I'm going to give you it in single notes and then harmony. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. Plays on the original, and I have to admit I've never played it before, but I think it's quite nice. Then we have the bass bit, which goes, and then four bars of kind of bass solo, but the bass not doing very much. And again, people will often leave this bit out. You may decide to do a little solo yourself there, and you may fall out seriously with the bass player if that happened to be his big moment of the night. It may be worth checking out just what the bass player intends to do in that little bit, because if that's his moment for the night and you're playing all over it, then you're not going to be popular. Right, let's into the next verse, and here I've got a much more standard fiddle type thing to do, which is basically offbeats. So let's go through from that bass bit and into there. Here we go. Smoother backing, and with double stops, just a bit more interesting than the chops, but you could do the chops all the way through if you wanted. Then into the bridge, similar chops again, but we also have this line when it's going from the G down to the E minor, and that's well worth knowing. That's single line, that's the double line. Let's just do that. Mm-hmm. And then we got another chorus, but I'm going to show you a solo here. It fades out on the original. So you may or may not get a solo. If you do, what I tend to do with Van Morrison songs is to play them all in major pentatonic scales. And this is my little joke, because that's what Van Morrison does on the sax pretty much all the time. I'm sure no one has ever told him off for doing that. A friend of mine was once on stage playing fiddle with Van Morrison, and he didn't come off well from the experience. But yes, so it does kind of fit in with his songs to do that. So I'm going to play you out with a little solo. Hope you enjoyed this, and I'll see you again soon.